Hey guys, welcome to my home decor slash home tour. I'm not gonna start from the outside of my house just because of safety reasons, so the tour is gonna be all inside today. The reason I'm doing this is because I put a poll up on my Twitter and had you guys vote on what type of video you wanted to see this Monday, and home decor won, which I think is really interesting because I'm not an interior decorator. I really am not qualified to make this video at all. But I think you guys just wanted to see the inside of my house, so let's get started. These fabulous curtains here are from Target. These are really nothing special. I've had these for quite a long time. And as well as the curtain rod, all of this entire set is from Target. Now, if it were up to me, I would have these curtains touch the floor, but I feel like they work, it's okay. I don't know. I think that it's decent, but if it were up to me, all of the curtains in the house would touch the floor. This is our dining area, and this light fixture right here, and it looks like a spider, is from, I ordered it on Wayfair, and I can't remember the name of the designer who made this light fixture. They're kind of a warehouse feel. Moving on to our dining table, all of the decor on this dining table is from Pier 1 Imports. These jars are from Pier 1 Imports. It has a drop candle holder in them. Inside the candle holders that I chose are a wood type finish with a little bit of a glittery, a glittery coat. And just to finish it, there's pine cones in the bottom. Now, mind you, whenever I bought this decor, it was getting close to winter. So I think that this has a very winter type feel to it, and I think that I want to go ahead and switch out the pine cones with something else that'll make it look more springish. This table runner is from Pier 1 Imports, as well as this little beaded applique right here. And the candle inside here smells amazing. I think all the candles at Pier 1 Imports smell phenomenal. Moving on to this beautiful table that you see here that I'm sure you're wondering where it's from. My husband actually made this table, and I'm gonna let him tell you about it right now.
So what we have here is a 7 foot farm style kitchen table. We went to Home Depot and got 2x4s, 4x1 inch boards, and some longer runners for the top, and it's all made out of pine. It went together pretty easy. We got the plans from Pinterest, so we can upload those if you want to make your own. It was pretty easy. It only really took me maybe a couple hours a day, and I got it done in a week. So on the top and for all the finish, we did like a darker walnut color, which is kind of the scheme that we wanted to go with. And yeah, it was really easy to do. And it was a lot cheaper than buying one. I think they cost like $1,200. So it's not perfect, but
it cost $1,200 if you were to buy it, right?
Yeah, if you wanted to buy it. I think we got all the material. If you have saws and all that kind of stuff to cut and a drill, I think the material was under like $250. So for about $250, if you have the other stuff, you can make one.
To finish this off, we went ahead and bought our dining room chairs from Wayfair. And we love these chairs. They came in sets of two, and the only thing that we weren't absolutely thrilled with is that the wood does not match our finish for our table exactly. And we were thinking about possibly doing maybe sanding them down and trying to refinish them to match the table, but at the end of the day, they don't look bad, and we don't want to ruin these chairs. You can get these chairs on Wayfair, and I think that I just said they come in sets of two, and I think for the entire 8-person set, we got these for about $629. This piece right here is actually asked about a lot, and I used to film my videos in front of it when I first started my pregnancy vlogs. This piece is also from Pier 1, and it's just a mirrored, like, I think the word would be like a mosaic type, and I absolutely love this piece. It wasn't very expensive, although I don't remember the exact dollar amount. It's at Pier 1 Imports. mirror right here. I'm really, really thinking that I got this at Walmart back in my college days. And I don't know. I know that this mirror was inexpensive, but when you put it in a room like this mixed with, you know, pieces from Pier 1 and pieces that are a little bit higher end, it makes these pieces look higher end that are from Target or from, say, Walmart or somewhere that has discount home decor. When you jazz it up with other items that people know are high-end or that look high-end, it makes your whole room end up looking high-end. Moving into our entryway, we have a beautiful mirror that is actually kind of more sentimental than it is for visual effect. This mirror is from Mexico, and it was actually in the ranch house that my dad lived in before. Whoops, I think I made it crooked.
Made it all cattywampus.
This was in the ranch house that my dad lived in before he passed away. And so when we brought it to our new home, we wanted to put it somewhere really special, so we thought that the entryway would be a great place for it. My decor on my entry table here, this was a gift that I got for Christmas from a boutique in Colorado. I went ahead and put three little pillar candles here from Hobby Lobby on top of a circular mirror. Now I'm gonna move over to Nick again so that he can tell you about this entryway table that he made with his own bare hands.
So what we have here, same color tone as we used for the kitchen table. Pretty much Aaron found a table on the internet that was extremely expensive. So naturally I found something else that I could make myself. These are 4-inch by 1-inch boards, and I ran them across the top with one on each end, I guess, just for a little bit more of a design feature. And then I did the same thing all the way across the bottom to give it some support so it wouldn't fall apart. On the bottom, I ran 4-inch boards across just like the top, just again for some more of a design feature. And below for the brace is a 2x4, and then just a square 4-inch board at the bottom for the foot to give it a little bit more design. And then we were looking originally at some wood pillars, and they're super expensive. They're like $200 a piece. So instead of doing that, we went to Hobby Lobby and we found some of these, like, I don't know if they're like ceramic or something, that were really cheap. They're like $30, and so we bought two of those and then used some wood fill and some like mud for drywall to kind of even it out, and glued them on. So it's not exactly probably gonna move from this spot, but it looks okay. It looks pretty cool, and it's durable enough so you put stuff on it. It's not really gonna go anywhere. So again, there's really not a plan for this. I just found something online and tried to make something that looked like it. So if you need the plans, I guess I could write some up, but yeah.
Let us know in the comments if your husband really, if he actually thinks that he will make this. We would have no problem writing up the plans for you if you really are going to do it. But I want to see pictures. These light fixtures above me are kind of a chandelier type of entry light. And I got these also on Wayfair, which I adore Wayfair. I think that is pretty evident. I want to say I'm probably super off on this price, but I just have a feeling these were around $130 a piece. I really think that they were. So they're fairly inexpensive, and I think that they look gorgeous for an entryway. Moving on, another piece from the ranch, which this mat and frame, all of this is very worn and rugged, and just the reason we haven't rematted and reframed this is because this was also a piece from my dad's house. He made this himself. And he found these pieces right here that are shown in this frame, and he made this himself. So I don't want to make any changes to it because it's just a really sentimental piece to me, and I'm gonna just keep it the way that it is. This is how you get to our garage. Our garage is through this way. I would show it to you, but it's a disaster. Once Nick gets it all man-holed up, I will show you guys the garage, but not yet.
Man-hole?
Once Nick
I've never heard that term.
Man-holed up, like a manhole, right?
A man cave? Okay, not man a man. A manhole sounds dirty.
Okay, once he turns into a man cave, I will show it to you. Here next to where we go outside to the garage, I just hung this little hook piece right here from IKEA. And we just hang our keys and the leashes and sunglasses sometimes right here because it's very convenient. We got this W piece as a gift from one of my friends at our engagement party. One of Nick's favorite things that we have here is our beautiful nest. Through this door right here is our coat closet. Through this door right here is our very clean laundry room. Eventually in this room, I would like to have Nick do some shelving here, some wood shelving. I just have a little hanger on the wall for our iron. And we have our drying rack and our ironing board. This laundry cart is from Crate and Barrel, and it has three sections for whites, colors, and darks. You don't need to show them our dirty laundry. And I like this because I can wheel it from our bedroom into here, and that's been really helpful with being pregnant because lifting is not fun. I have put a fabulous gray rug in here from Target Field Crest Luxury. As you continue walking in to our kitchen from the laundry room area, this is our kitchen. The major parts of our kitchen are obviously this black granite countertop here on our island, as well as the black granite countertops throughout the rest of the kitchen. And the wood finish is kind of like a cherry wood color. We probably wouldn't have chosen cherry wood if we were the ones who designed this house, but it actually, I think, looks okay. I would have probably chosen a dark wood if I were the one designing this kitchen. But I do love my black countertops, my black granite countertops. I think they are gorgeous. All of our appliances are stainless steel Whirlpool, very run of the mill. And over here on our fridge, on our fridge, we have this really nice St. Patrick's Day garland from Target to be getting into the festive St. Patrick's Day season. Above our fridge right here, you will see a clock that is from either Target or Walmart, I can guarantee you, because that was from college. This is a little mini wine holder from Target. We have some extra wine up here. In the back there, you'll see a sterling silver bowl that was a wedding gift that I have kind of displayed because I would like to have it out to show people, but there's really no room for it, so I put it back there. These A and N, this has an N on it, these little twine wine bottles, these are from Etsy. And I got those as decor for our wedding bar, and we decided to put them in here because they look really awesome. This wooden frame back here that you see is a picture of Nick and I when we first started dating. This was us out at the club, like right when we first met. And I really love that picture of us. And I actually bedazzled that frame with glitter. The center part of it used to have a bow, but it was purple, so I ripped it off so that it would match with the kitchen. So that's why there's no glitter on that centerpiece. We have vines across the top of the cabinets. These vines are from Hobby Lobby, as well as the grapes that you'll see sporadically placed throughout the vines. Up there you'll also see a little cat, which probably is kind of hard to see. That is an Egyptian cat. And there are two lanterns up there as well, because Nick said that he thought we should have some little trinkets up there rather than just vines. So there are two lanterns up there, as well as an Egyptian elephant. We have our knife block right here. We have a little cuisine art holder for our utensils. This cutting board was a gift for our wedding. We've got a fruit basket holder right there. This was a wedding gift. The fruit basket was a wedding gift. This was also a wedding gift. This is a Martha Stewart spice holder. This is one of our favorite things that we have in our kitchen on display, because this is a sterling silver platter that was given to us as a wedding gift, and we are in love with it. So obviously we had to have that displayed. I also have a stainless steel paper towel holder. This hand soap and hand lotion piece right here is from William Sonoma, and it was a gift. This is a Lorna Doone, I'm pretty sure. Nope, it's a Nora Fleming. This is a Nora Fleming piece that I showed you guys in one of my What I Ate vlogs, and these are interchangeable for the different holidays. This one is obviously for St. Patrick's Day, so I have that out, and it has a little flower holder, so I always have a really cute fresh flower sticking out right there. I have one of our engagement pictures out here on the counter as well, as you can see. We have our Keurig that we can't live without, our Aero Latte frother next to it, as well as a little coffee trolley, or whatever it's called, a coffee carousel. And this was a wedding gift from Helen Kim, who was on my season of Big Brother. She sent this to us as a wedding gift, and we were looking everywhere to get a new keg to put in it for Nick, and we have to wait till the liquor store opens because it's Sunday. This curtain is from Target, obviously. All of my stuff is from Target. I guess not obviously, but it's from Target. And we just have it on a really simple rod. Above that, I love this canvas that is from Hobby Lobby. I just love this bistro. Like, I don't know. I just love looking at this canvas. It just makes me really happy. And I think that it looks really, really great in our kitchen. I made a piece right here with this silver bowl that I got from, where do you guys think? Target. Inside the bowl, I just put, these are just wine corks throughout the years that I've collected, wine and champagne corks that I've collected throughout the years. And I just decided to put them in here and make my own little centerpiece. Inside here, I have one of my favorite candles, which is Mahogany Coconut. And this is by White Barn, which is just the upscale, Bath & Body Works scent. These used to be in great condition, but we have a little kitten who is 6 months old. And as you can see, there's lots of kitten scratch marks from her clawing and pulling herself up and just really scratching this thing to pieces. But I love that this is a winged back design with like the nail details. These are from Target Online. Everything's from Target. These are from Target Online, and I want to say a piece, they were about, I think they were $115 a piece, but I got a really good deal because they were on sale for like 15%, 15 to 20% off. And I also have my Target card, so I got an additional 5% off. This is our kitchen rug, and it is from Pier 1. I really just like the shaggy look of this rug. Moving on to this wall decor to the left of our pantry, I have three wall pieces that I really love. These two, of course, are from Target. This little wooden star and this wooden love makes a house a home quote. And right here, the signature cocktail board, I had this made on Etsy because these were actually the signature cocktails that we had at our wedding. So I decided to keep it and hang it up in our house. One of my favorite parts of this room is this canvas that I had made on Shutterfly. You just design your own canvas. And I put a bunch of pictures from our engagement photo shoot, and it says the Williams. I love that. We just got these curtains and curtain rod today because we were in dire need of curtains in this room. So we just set these up. These are from Home Depot, both of them. It's Martha Stewart collection drapes, and the rod is from Home Depot as well. Also on this wall, I'm sure you can see here, we have more pieces from the ranch house that my dad made. And this room has a really Western feel, so they go really well with the room. Nick and I both had this little swivel love seat. Nick had it in college and I had mine in college. And somehow mine made it all the way to our house here. So I really like it. I don't know how it's not dirtier by now, but this is just a suede cushion and a leather back. Zell's toys are always right here in this bin, even though she spreads them sporadically throughout the house at all times. This leather chair right here is from Target and has tons of scratch marks from Duchess on it. I've just learned that I need to just live with it, I guess, because it's never gonna change. This throw pillow here is from another one of my favorite stores, Pier 1 Imports. Right here, this little panel that you see behind the light fixture is from Hobby Lobby. These lights are from Target Online. This picture right here was given to me by a really good friend of my dad's. He had it matted for me, and we hung it in here because it really goes with the room. Down here is a basket for blankets. My favorite blanket ever from Target is the Simply Shabby Chic collection from Target. So comfortable, and it's huge, so it's like the best snuggling blanket ever for watching movies. These two things, the vase as well as these rustic Western flowers, this is from Pier 1. This little dome right here with the flower in it, this was my father's boutonniere for my wedding that we had on his memory table. He was not at my wedding, he had passed away, so we gave him like a tribute, and this was the boutonniere that I had for him at the wedding. I have two picture frames right here. This one was from Christmas. It was a Christmas gift from my mother-in-law. And this one I ordered either on Wayfair or Overstock.com when we first moved into our apartment together. I had this made on Etsy, and now that I look at it, it's basically just 3 2x4s, right, honey? These are 2x4s, aren't they?
Mm-hmm. No.
Well, 3 pieces of wood.
4-inch boards.
4-inch boards stapled together and then Gorilla glued together, and then she stenciled this on. So honestly, you could make your own and it would be so easy, but on Etsy, I didn't realize how it was done, but now I feel like this would be really easy to make if you want one for your house. And I just have it sitting on an easel, but I had this made for our wedding. This right here is just a candle holder, and it has a big, huge candle inside here. It looks really pretty whenever the candle's burning because it shows through these little shells, and especially if like the lights are off and it's dim in here, this is just a gorgeous like kind of glow. This is our favorite piece that we have in our whole house, I think, just because it's also from the ranch house and my dad made this as well. And I don't have any red or this burnt orange color anywhere really in the house, but just like the other ones, I don't want to redo it because it's just really special to me in its original condition.
Over here, I have an entertainment system that I built. Again, we used the walnut finish, and basically we wanted something a little bit more rustic. That was kind of the theme that we were going with. And I had found a couple of things online with the barn doors, which I thought were really cool. And we definitely wanted something big to go underneath the TV. So instead of buying an entertainment system, we found some plans for this, and it really wasn't that difficult to make. It did take me a while. The hardest part was definitely the hardware for the sliding door. But once I got the frame together, it really went together pretty well. And probably my favorite part's the detail on the front of the doors. Pretty much with this, again, a lot of 1x4s, and then I think that was a 2x1 that we used for the trim. This took me a couple weeks to make, but if you wanted to buy one like this, it'd cost a couple $1,000 probably. So again, it's not perfect, and the wood is definitely a little bit warped on the top, which is expected. Anytime you buy this kind of pine lumber, it's gonna warp a little bit, but it kind of adds to the personality of it, I guess, as far as being homemade. So the plans for this came from Anna White, who does a lot of build your own furniture on Pinterest. And I believe the table came from Anna White too. So I wanted to call out to my girl, Anna White.
Nick loves her. The decor items that I have inside here are old pictures that were also in the ranch house. This is a photo of my dad and I out on the ranch, and I'm pouring corn out for the goats. That's my dad and I together out on the ranch. I have a basket underneath on this side. It has a lot of cat toys in it underneath here. On this side, I have two pictures that were taken by National Geographic when they came out to our ranch to do a segment, or I guess an article, on the ranches of West Texas. And this is the photo that they took of my dad. This frame is really old because it was in the ranch house. And this is the photo that they took of me. And this is actually the photo that they featured in the National Geographic issue about ranches of West Texas.
The table came from a good friend of mine. He was moving into a new apartment and wanted to get rid of this. So it's a pretty nice granite table. So I said that I would take it, and Erin told me absolutely not.
I did
because
not.
She didn't see the picture. She didn't know what it looked like. She just thought that I had found a coffee table. So I brought it home, and she decided that she liked it. So that's why it lives here.
I love it.
Glass
mirrored
mirror here.
Mirrored tray
is from Williams and Sonoma. And it's a pretty nice little holder here for some magazines and some remote controls. And this rug is the dog that we had before Zell. Did you hear that, Zell?
This gray rug is actually from Costco, and it's like a fake sheepskin rug, and I love that rug. It was only $100, and I think that it looks really cool underneath this new marble table that we have. Zell is modeling our IKEA couch that we cannot wait to get rid of. This L-shaped demon that we bought for our very first apartment together. Zell loves it, the animals love it, but it is just not the quality we were hoping for, but I guess that's expected when you buy an $800 IKEA couch. These pillows are from, the cream ones are from Target, and they have kind of a shimmer to them. And these gold ones here are from Pier 1, and I have them in two places on the couch. And in between our kitchen and living room are these chocolate curtains from Target. I kind of did like a semi-beach theme for this room.
Late.
This mirror right here, I want to say, is from Target or possibly Home Depot. I really am not thinking Walmart, but I guess it could be because I may have purchased this in college. I really don't think so. I'm really leaning towards Hobby Lobby or Target. This Pool and Cabana sign, I know, is from Target for sure. These votives are from Target, and I have some LED candles inside them that flicker, and they're really pretty. This waste basket right here was a gift for our wedding. It was on my registry from either Williams-Sonoma or Crate and Barrel. I have this pump soap dispenser from Target that needs to be cleaned off, but this is from Target. This right here is a bowl of shells from our honeymoon in Grenada. So we have some really cute things here that remind us of our honeymoon in Grenada. In every bathroom of my house, I have wallflowers, and this is the pineapple design, and I just change out the scent. This room right here is Duchess's room, and Nick installed this little cat entryway right here that I think is pretty dusty and probably is ready to be cleaned. But Nick installed that little cat entryway. When you take a peek inside, it's a little cat room.
Hold your breath.
Because nobody likes to see a cat box out anywhere. It's not very nice to have a cat box out in the open. Why is my bed not made, you ask? The reason is because my comforter is still at the dry cleaners. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna insert a picture right here in the video so that you can see what my bed looks all made and beautified. My comforter, I have a lot of people ask where my comforter and pillows and my whole bed set is from. My comforter I actually ordered from Macy's online. The brand is J. Queen New York, if you want to look that up. The sheets are also from Macy's. I'm not exactly sure of the brand, but these are amazing, amazing sheets. Like, they're extremely soft. We love them. Our bed frame is a wingback design with the nailed details from Wayfair. And we ordered this when it was on a 70% off deal on Wayfair. On my side of the bed, we have Zell's bed and Duchess's bed. Although Duchess never sleeps in her own bed, she always sleeps in Zell's bed. Our nightstands are from Wayfair, and I just, even though they don't exactly match the theme of my room, I just liked the way that they kind of look like, I don't know how to explain it, but they remind me of like a rock star kind of with the silver edging. I don't know. It just reminds me of like a guitar case or something, or I don't know what I have on my mind for these, but I really like the silver edging and I like that they cross at the bottom. Our lamps are from where else but Target Online, and they're mercury glass, and they really kind of tie everything together. Whenever I have my comforter actually on the bed, this whole look is really tied together with these mercury glass lamps. Next to our bed, we have this frame right here that was a wedding gift. This is a memory angel from Liza Stinton from Big Brother Canada. She sent me this when my dad passed away, so I keep it right here. This is a Kate Spade ring holder so that when I take my jewelry off, if I'm in bed, I can just pop them on here. And this is, like I said, Kate Spade. It was a gift for my bachelorette party. And Meredith, my business partner and friend, gave me this spa room. It has like a light. I don't think it's plugged in, but this lights up and it like fades different colors, and it has like a steam aromatherapy mist that comes out, and you can put any essential oils in it, and it's like an aromatherapy spa thing. It's amazing.
Aaron and I, this is one of the first, one of the first couple dates that we went on. I got a nice matching lamp, just like the mercury one Aaron has over there. I think that was right, mercury, right? All right, it looks pretty cool. It's gold and stuff. And I got the trimmed Rockstar, what is it?
Nightstand.
Nightstand. Got the nightstand there.
Do not pull your Glock out. This mirror was purchased, I will be completely honest right here. This mirror was purchased for shameless selfie taking, but the light has to be just right because obviously the windows are behind you right now. So when you're trying to stand here and take a selfie, the light from back there comes in and it just really throws off your selfie game. But there was no other place to put it. So this is kind of like a failed selfie mirror attempt. Welcome to our master bathroom. Come inside. This is our little square box shower that Nick thinks is really practical. Although, maybe for him, but when you have to shave and do all sorts of things in a shower, you need a lot more room. There's no stool to sit on. It's probably my least favorite part of this bathroom. This is our garden bathtub. And I do spend a lot of time in this bathtub. I love taking baths, and I've been taking a lot recently. This window behind the bathtub, we haven't decided exactly what we're going to do to it yet. We really would like to have shutters. Nick is thinking of possibly making something for it, so we're going to see. Stay tuned. I'll definitely post pictures when we figure out what we're going to do to this window, but it needs something done to it. This little giraffe right here is a gift from my friend Haley. These two little goblets right here are from Hobby Lobby, and they have LED candles inside that have a really nice glow at night. I just put these never been used towels right here as decor. They've never been touched, and that's why they're so crisp and flat. If you wash them first, they really do not stay like this. You need to make sure they're brand new if you want them to stay looking crisp. This is one of my bridal portraits that we had featured at our wedding, and I thought that it looked really good in this room. Over here, we have a painting that was done of one of our pictures from our wedding, and this is obviously hand-painted, and it's by Ryan T. Dalgleish, if I'm saying that right. His last name is spelled D-A-L-G-L-I-E-S-H. And you can actually find him on Instagram if you want to have him paint one of your photos from your wedding for you, because this is absolutely stunning and one of my favorite gifts that we received. On our bathroom countertop, there's not much because I don't like very much clutter. So I have a picture of my dad and I up here from when I was really little in this crystal frame that was a gift, so I don't know where this frame is from. I have a little jar from Etsy where I put Q-tips and cotton balls. These soap dispensers are from Target. This little flower ball is from Hobby Lobby. This is a crystal jewelry holder that was from my mother-in-law, and it just has bobby pins in it right now. And I have my perfume out that I don't use very much perfume right now because I'm pregnant, but this is Victoria's Secret Scandalous. And then I have this is a new purchase, and I love this. Honey, this is a new purchase, and I love this. This is just a magnifying mirror, and it lights up, and it's kind of a must-have for your bathroom. Once again, another wallflower from Bath & Body Works. That's Guava Colada scent. Here's our water closet. Come into the toilet room.
What's that painting behind you?
This painting is a Love is Art painting. I just have a full-length mirror right here, and I'll have Nick come in and show you the two mirrors that I have hanging above the toilet that are from either Target, Hobby Lobby, or Walmart. It's been a long time.
You forgot to talk about the scale.
And our health-o-meter scale.
That's where business gets done.
Porcelain throne.
That's where business gets undone.
Okay. And our two little mirrors. This is Nick's side. This is very organized.
Very well organized.
Nick did these cubbies for us, which I thought was very nice. And this is my side.
Where all the hangers go to die.
It's so smashed in here. I need to move some more stuff upstairs. I have a whole separate closet upstairs for clothes because there's not enough room in here.
Walk with me.
Okay, you can pause it.
Walk and talk.
You can pause it now.
Walk and talk.
Honey?
We're making it right now.
Honey, pause the video. She doesn't care.
Duchess. What are you doing?
Come on, babe. And now I'm gonna take you upstairs. But first, let me show you this portrait of me from my bridal portraits. This was our wedding tree, so you were supposed to sign your name in one of the leaves if you were a guest at our wedding. And we ended up having about 200 people there, and only, I don't know how many leaves got signed, but way less leaves got signed than should have been signed. You probably recognize this frame that has nothing in it because this is where I take my weekly pregnancy bump shot. And that's why it's blank, because I just kind of Photoshop it into the hole. Like, does that look familiar? Behind you is off limits. I'm not done with my loft work area yet, and so I'm not going to be showing that in this video. But when I have it finished, I will go ahead and show that to you guys, because I know a lot of people want to see my loft, but I'm just going to go ahead and wait on that one. Follow me.
Over to the cat stand.
Oh, this is Duchess's cat stand. Nick built this for her, and it's actually really cool. She didn't use it at first, but now she's starting to warm up to it, and really she's starting to love her cat tree is what I call it. This is a lamp from Target, and we just threw it in this hallway whenever we moved here because there's really nowhere else for it in our house. So this is our Target lamp, and I'm talking about this. And that is in the shot. Why are you doing that? This is just the linen closet. This is a picture of my dad and I when I was really little, so I wanted to hang it in this, dang, my tan looks really bad. So I wanted to hang it in this hallway. Two little crates here for extra storage. This is one of the guest bathrooms. This is this little vase is from Hobby Lobby, and all of the little stuff in here is from Pier 1, and some of it's from Hobby Lobby, some of it's from Pier 1. It's kind of like a mixture of different vase fillers. This little dome globey thing is from Hobby Lobby with a little candle in it. This was from my high school sweetheart, gave me this. This vase has stones in it from Ireland. When he went to Ireland, he picked up these stones from me on the beach, and shells. and he put them together with this candle that has a little starfish in it. The soap dispenser and toothbrush holder are both mercury glass from Target. And I have a little tiny frame right here with a picture of me and some of my girls from our engagement party night. I have another wallflower right here. This hand towel is from Target. I have another photo of my dad and I framed right here. Underneath here, this is my bouquet from my bridal portraits, and it's been dried. So I put it in this little, I think this is a candle holder, but I put it in there just so that I could have it on display. This piece right here is from Bed Bath & Beyond. And again, I have some little towels here on display. I'm not sure where the shower curtain is from, but these shower rings are also from Target. This brown rug right here is from Target, and the reason it's all cattywampus is because this door always gets caught on it. So that is Target, and this one is a Wamsutta from Bed Bath & Beyond. This room right here is the nursery, which I'm going to do a whole separate nursery tour, so you're going to have to stay tuned for that one. This is our guest room. These little sunburst mirrors are from Target. When I moved into my very first apartment, I had this poster framed because I love Sex and the City and Sarah Jessica Parker. So I had this framed, and it kind of like inspired my whole theme for my apartment, which was like Morocco. And it's a custom frame. These two candle holders, as well as the candles in them, are from Target. I have lamps right here that are both from IKEA. Both of the nightstands on each side, they're the exact same nightstand. One's just a little bit bigger, and they're from IKEA. I have a candle holder from Hobby Lobby right here with just a regular candle from Target in it. This bedding was a wedding gift. I want to say this bedding is from Target. I have a ton of just different pillows from everywhere. This pillow was a wedding gift. These are from Pier 1 Imports, and the other ones are just kind of like, who knows where they're from. I've accumulated pillows from throughout the years. It's just an Egyptian elephant art piece. This curtain panel is either from Target or Bed Bath & Beyond on a just very plain curtain rod. And once again, I have my IKEA lamp and nightstand next to this little Target Nate Berkus Target bowl to put your jewelry in when you stay in our guest room. This little candle holder is from Hobby Lobby, but I glittered it myself, obviously. And I have another candle on this side. This kind of little wall piece is from Hobby Lobby. This rug right here is Nate Berkus from Target. This one is Wamsutta from Bed Bath & Beyond. The shower curtain and shower hooks are from Target. This little hand towel is from Target. These two pieces right here are both from Bed Bath & Beyond, the ones that are on top of the toilet. The gold tray and gold soap dispenser are both from Target, the Nate Berkus. I made this. It's like paper mache. I made this little jar, and it has a tea light, an LED tea light in it. This little giraffe was a gift from my mom, and it's kind of like a secret jewelry holder if you want to put your rings in here when you come stay at our house. And then I have another wallflower. Okay guys, thank you so much for watching my home decor video. You saw everything in my house except for my loft slash office, the nursery, and Nick's office. Nick's office is always a disaster. If it ever clears up, I'll show it to you guys. The nursery, I'll be doing a full nursery room tour when it's done. And my office slash loft, I will also show you guys once I have it completed. But anyway, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I'll see you guys on Wednesday for my pregnancy update. Bye.